First off, Paul, I just want to say thank you letting the foundation guys follow you, film another practice round.
Of course, yeah, it was my pleasure.
Yep, so I'm just going to ask you a few questions about this course. I know this is going to be the first course that you're going to play, so... So you've been out here for about 2 weeks. So what do you think after, you know, 2 weeks playing this is going to be your attack plan?
Well, I got to play this one for the Ledgestone Open each year, so there hasn't been really anything that's changed besides one basket that moved back to its original spot. But I feel like I play this course pretty aggressive compared to most, mm-hmm. but I feel like I'm executing all those shots now than I have previously. So it's, if I can execute that game plan, it's going to work out great. Yeah, I think it'll be a fun world if that happens.
Yeah. So if any, because I know a lot of these holes out here are just wide open, do you think there are any separating holes in this course? And if there are, which ones are they?
Oh, definitely. There's a lot of them. I could go through the whole course, honestly. and the reason for that is because there's so much out of bounds. You know, one, you could take a big number. Two, you could take a big number. Three, you could take a big number. So, like, I could literally go for all 18 holes because of the OB factor that they have. They're all separators. The ones that aren't separators is hole 10, 11. That's the only one.
Yeah. All right. So I know before when we were playing, you said that the course is playing a little different because the ground is wet. So how many strokes different do you think that this course would play if the ground was wet versus if it was dry?
I don't know if I'd say it's like give or take stroke different. I think it's just the way that you have to play it.
Okay.
When it's dry, everything you know is going to be skippy. It's going to be running a little bit more on the greens and the fairways. But now with it being wet, It could stick in some points on the side of the hills. It kind of, the wet grass kind of grabs it better, but on the flat ground it kind of skips a little bit more. So it's kind of, if you know that, there won't be any stroke swings. It's just knowing how the course is playing, and you'll be fine.
Okay. So what do you think that the hot round is going to be out here this week?
I have no clue. Same probably as Northwood, low. Okay. I could see one getting in the 40s here. Be really hard to see that over at Northwood. But again, low 50s.
Okay. And if you could change one thing about this course, if you could, what would it be?
I think I would just change the setting. I think I said that over at the same course. I would just make it to where it's a disc golf course only. Mm-hmm. And instead of having roads as OB, it'd be some kind of water hazard or something.
Right.
So.
Okay.
But the baseball field, yeah, I gotta share this. I think if we're not in Chicago, but we're outside of Chicago, mm-hmm. you know, that's the closest major city. Besides Peoria, I think it'd be really cool if they did kind of like a Wrigley Field style and just ivied the whole thing.
That'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, so.
That'd be cool.
I know, whatever it is, I'm gonna let them know.
Okay. Well, thank you, Paul. We appreciate it. Good luck this week. Thanks for watching, guys. We hope you liked the video. If you haven't already, subscribe to us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and then go over to patreon.com and search Foundation Disc Golf. We have a lot of extra content over there that you guys can get. So, just, yeah. See you guys next time.